The main event, best 2 out of 3 falls to a finish, from Buffalo, New York, weighing 258, the Blaisdell Pizza King, Ilio DiPaolo. His opponent, from Hamilton, Ontario, weighing 261, the blonde Adonis, Johnny Powerlock Powers.
Well, it's not too much trouble telling where these alliance of the fans is tonight. They're all for Ilio DiPaolo, the Pizza King from Blaisdell, against Johnny Powers, the youngster from Hamilton, Ontario. Now, you may notice Johnny Barron standing in the corner there, and you certainly notice Martino Angelo coming out with his boy, Johnny Powers. And when Angelo came into the ring, Ilio DiPaolo left the ring to go back to the dressing room to get Johnny Barron to come out here to represent him. And the question is, apparently in DiPaolo's mind, that if Martino Angelo, who is a wrestler, can be a second for Johnny Powers, then he needs one too. And that's why Johnny Barron is in the ring. Now this is 2 falls out of 3, and the count, this one may be over quick. Johnny Powers using the... He came over there very quickly before Ilio DiPaolo got his robe off. The bell is not yet rung. This match is not officially underway. There it is. There's the bell. And Powers comes right out now on the strength of that first assault. And he definitely has Ilio on the run. Johnny Powers taking quick advantage here as come on quickly to get Ilio DiPaolo. There's a body slam, and he's got Ilio in bad shape. He set him up early. And DiPaolo, of course, is a crowd favorite. But so far, the favorite's having a rough time. It's kind of like if you're a southerner, it's Lee Surrending here at Gettysburg. Or Appomattox, is that where it was? Well, Johnny Powers was quickly taking control, and Ilio has not yet gotten out of his robe, so to speak. Ilio at the moment outside the ring, and Joe Moscato, the referee, trying to bring some order here to this main event. Contrast in colors here with Ilio DiPaolo. Neapolitan dark, black hair, swarthy. The blonde Johnny Powers, light red trunk, now taking it. And he dished it out tremendously in the first few minutes. Now it's Ilio DiPaolo who's dishing it out. And Joe Moscato trying to pull him off. And why, I don't know. We'll find out. Apparently there was an illegal move in there. The bell is rung, and Joe Moscato holding on to Ilio. And Ilio is not content. So the battle now going on outside the ring. Johnny Powers underneath the ring. The bell is rung. Apparently ending this first fall. It's a 2 out of 3 a fall affair. Now Ilio really dishing it out to Johnny Powers. And we'll get the official decision on it. Apparently Powers is the winner. Johnny Powers the winner. And we'll find out why as Matty Weiss gets the complete explanation from Joe Moscato. A penalty call against Elio Di Paolo. The time, 2:45. The winner, Johnny Powerlock Powers. Penalty call against Elio Di Paolo. Well, it's just shows you. Now Elio is working on Martino Edgar, the manager. Oh, we got a real Johnny book going here. Johnny Barron came in to give Martino Edgar an elbow. Johnny Powers, who is lying in the corner begging for mercy, is the winner. And Elio Di Paolo, very upset about the decision, is pushing on Joe Moscato. We'll be back for the second fall. We have another one coming up. Well, we better stay with this. There's Johnny Barron now giving the elbow to Johnny Powers. Well, I'll tell you, you never know what's going to happen at Memorial Auditorium. And if you haven't been down here for a while or watch the wrestling action, I suggest you come down next Friday night. Well, we're between falls, and now we'll take a little time out, and we'll be back to pick up the second fall in 1 minute. All right, there's the bell for the second fall, and Elio Di Paolo, a real tiger. Look out, Joe Moscato. Boy, you almost got it that time. Di Paolo has come out a real raging maniac here in the second fall. Look at him go to work on Johnny Powers. And Powers responds with that knee to the stomach, which is one of his trademarks. Johnny Powers is unbeaten in this Buffalo ring. And Elio Di Paolo trying to take that mantle away from him tonight. But this Canadian youngster is strong and he's tough. Beautifully conditioned. Trying for the leg lock. He's trying for the power lock. The crowd knew it. The crowd knew he was trying for that leg lock. And Elio knew it. He wouldn't let him get to it. As a matter of fact, you'll notice Elio is working on those thighs, those legs of Johnny Powers, trying to sap the strength. He figures if he can take the strength out of those legs, the power lock will not be effective. Look at Johnny Barron coming in there now. That's what cost Elio Di Paolo the first fall. Elio working on a toe hold. Elio may be able to get a quit here if Johnny Powers can't take this pain. He's got that toe hold going on pretty good. Main event at Memorial Auditorium. There's that knee to the stomach that Powers uses so well. He keeps throwing that big left knee into the stomach of his opponent. That's what he's doing right now. Look out here. He's got it. If he can hold him, Elio in the your place soon. There's my senior Angelo getting on the crowd, getting on the up to the ring. Tino Angelo is complaining that his boy was beaten on a fast count. A spectator rushed down the ringside and grabbed Martino Angelo as he came up on the ring apron to try to prevent that fall. Here's Manny White.
The time, 3 minutes, 52 seconds. The winner, Elio Di Paolo.
So we're all even, one fall apiece. Johnny Powers winning the first ball, Elio Di Paolo taking the second. And Johnny Powers got in too good shape after that airplane spin.